everybody, welcome back to my channel. Guess what we have today? Yes, baby, as you can see, we have company. Yes, we got plant work to do. It's been what?
About a year now. A year. Well, hell, a year and a week. About a year and almost about a week, or if not a week exact,
that I've had this beauty right here, this Monastera Albo Deliciosa Variegated Half Moon. Yes, she, all of that. All of that, baby, all of that. Yeah, see her? She gives you some mixed variegations on this side, on your left side here, and on my right, she gives you half moon. Isn't that just gorgeous? Isn't that, baby, just beautiful? Yes, just gorgeous, just gorgeous. And it is time to get her a new home. Yes, baby. She's been in this little bitty pot for over a year and a week, as I said. And yeah, it's time to upgrade her into a new home from this little bitty pot. And we're gonna slide her into this gallon. Okay? Yes. And I thank you guys for coming to my channel, to Cat's Plant Corner, which she started it off with, somewhat. Well, actually, technically, yes. Yes, I actually started off with African violets. Yes, my true first love. But anyhow, but yeah, nevertheless, if you've seen that video I put up, she cried because she lost her pole. Yeah, that's why we actually, we pot her up into something bigger to, so she can have her pole back in there to lean on, to lean or swing on, or sway on, however you want to do it. So yeah, but for all the newcomers, hello, welcome. She beauty here. She says hello and welcome. Hello, everybody. But yes, I thank you guys for coming and joining us. If you haven't already, please subscribe. If you're new here, welcome. Please join us. We'd love to have you. Like I said, please like, comment, and subscribe while you're here. So let's get into this repotting mission. We got some mess to get into. Let's get our hands dirty. So let's cue this intro. Okay. Welcome back, guys. Now, for the soil mixture I will be using for that precious beauty right there is the Orchid Bark Mix, the special mix, which comes with the coco core, some perlite, and what else is in here? Some perlite, cocoa chips. And speaking of cocoa chips, I have this roll here. It's the small roll of cocoa chips that I have separately. Here is some plant soil, some more perlite to add with the mixture, give you some more aerage. And down here at the bottom is some sand, more erich, some more cocoa culture, and my little blecker balls as well. And here is some organic soil, and this is some tree fern as well. And over in this corner here is some bone, child, what's the name of it? Some other stuff, child. Some, well, I'll tell you if it comes to me. If not, I'll put it in the description at the bottom. I'm not gonna rack my brain, child, whatever it is. And then also, here, I will be putting in some saving to keep the bugs away. Because I No, we won't be doing the bugs. No, ma'am. And here is some fresh, some broadcastings, some footage for the bed. And a little bag of extra little plant soil, just in case I need it, because it is mainly herbage, okay? Mainly herbage, just in case I need it. Now, let me drop you down so you can see what we're talking about, what's going on in her pot, baby. All right. Let's see what's in here. Let's see what a year of growth has done for her. Oh, yeah. We got rootage at the bottom. It is been time. Let's see there. It's time of year, some room. Let's not break them. Let's not break them. Let's pull this out. I haven't watered it. You see the soil is dry. So I can simply just pull it out without having a hot mess. First off, I'm gonna need to shake up my soil. You made a much at you. Hurry up and get you together, because I will have a heart attack if you snap. Baby. Stay still now. Stay still. We're gonna get you together. Don't you still crying. I know you're crying. You need your support, I know. Though it just ain't, it just don't feel right. I know. Shake up all your goodness. Give your goodness some good old shaking. Good enough. Good. All right. See what it looks like after it's all mixed up here and ready to go. All right. And for her new home, like I said, it's going to be this gallon. It's a big difference. Huge difference from what she started off with and what she's going to be in it with. But believe me, it's suitable. Trust me. She'll be in it for a good minute. And at the bottom of the kitchen pot, I have some styrofoam. So, when I put the pot in there, it won't be hitting all the way at the bottom. Where the water is catching. Said extra. Let me fix that there. Catching the extra water. So, let's go ahead. And, should I get some bigger cocoa corn and put it in there? Let me just add this because it looks like I'm gonna need extra. I'm gonna need some more soil, it looks like. And I'm keeping it in the plastic pot. So it can hold that moisture, it won't run out. out too dry in this terracotta pot. Let's see, where are we at? Well, I'm going to take you in, Mr. Root. Perfect. Maybe a little bit more scoops. And you'll be in there all right. And your new home. Hold tight. Hold tight, baby. Hold tight. Okay, maybe 2.5. And the soil that she's in, we are definitely going to keep and just... Dump it in with her new home. Oh, lovely. Somebody got a grip on it. Well rooted. Look at that. She was ready to give some more food and more home, wasn't she? I should say so. Look at the roots. Look at that. So ready. Nice. Nice. Oh, now let me set her to the side and put you on hold to grab her pole. Okay, got her pole sitting in there in the tub. I had sprayed it down with water so it could be moist. Nice and wet, so when I place her in, I'm gonna let the pole do the watering. And let them get set up off the bat. And she is far away from the pen. Barf, I'm gonna go. She grew off of it, so she's gonna go. If you can see, it grew away, and I want to straighten her up so she can. Be nice, but I don't want to bother her too much, get her out of her comfort. Guess I'll loosen up some of these roots too. Which it don't matter because she's going to find a way around. Let's just try to line this baby up. Grab some Velcro, which I could not find the rest of it. Nowhere. My Velcro and my eggshells. Should have kept the ones my husband said. Do we need these? Do you want these?
Yeah, got some
So I thought I had some. So I thought some, but I just can't find it. But I looked everywhere it's supposed to be. Everything else is together with the eggshells, so I don't think I have any. Oh, maybe. Yeah, I do. Because I see a new leaf on me. I'm going to have to add. Which that root to go inside there, grow inside, so hopefully we won't have no problem of them doing so. Okay, I don't want to pull up too much, so this is about as far as I can get the pole up to her, per se. Get it close to her. Make sure this pole, because it looks like it's bit off. Okay, let's do this backfill in motion. Let's get this backfill in motion, baby. Just gonna fill it up to the top of the original fill. Won't be going over, well, not past the line. And that point. Right at the bottom. All right. Looking good, looking good. Looking real good. Make sure no air gaps is in here. So no hole is intact. Okay. She looks good. Looking good, looking good. I should say so. We'll just dump out the excess that came up and replace the fill. Then place back and we'll attach the second pole. Because she's a big girl. She's growing. And springtime is here. There's gonna be more growth to be done, to be had. And this pole is a lot smaller. But it's gonna have to work. Because I refuse to do any other. I am not. Nope. She can use exactly what's already been made. Okay. Now I'm gonna try to weave it through. Is not in here either. Oh goodness, it's gonna be here. Trying to get this doggone thing through Velcro. Not Velcro, this strap through zip tie. I'm gonna need to get a stick. Support stick. This water got it heavy. And it's gonna lean. And I don't want it to rock with it. Okay. I'll be back. Let me get the support stick. Okay. Back with some support. Got this support stick here. Just gonna slide it into the back. Show it all the way down. And zip tie it up. Start from the bottom, top here. Now, top is supported. Now I can support this back side here.
Okay. Got this backside supported there. All the way up. And some scissors. All right, scissors. Cut this access strap from the top so I can bring the strap side down. That should be good. As soon as the water go down and the pole dry up, should be easier for that support. Won't be want to lean so much. Okay. Now. Now let's treat it, get some saving, some bug away. Don't need no pests, no unwanted company. No, no, we don't need. But we're gonna get plenty of food though. That's what we're gonna do. Oh yes, we're gonna have lots of food to eat. Lots, lots, lots. So much to go. I'm just going to be pouring it in there. Just pouring it in there. Yes, I am. Take up all that because, why? Because I definitely didn't put none in the bottom half. So, I'm just going to let that do what it do. Mix that around a little bit. Can you see what I'm doing? Mixing it around. Child. You didn't see none of that. My bad. Mixing in sets, saving, and the worm casting. All right, guys, and ran out of memory and it cut off on me, but there's a finished process product. There you go, with all her glory in her new home. Let me. That right there concludes. I think I like it besides the weebity wobble. Get her settled in. This pole is kind of heavy. I'm gonna smash her. Ooh, there. Press them down. Make sure this pole is in here good. So you won't be doing no tilting, but yeah, she's done. This is what she looks like on the inside of her paw. That right there. Okay. Still got lots of free room, free soil, snap. Clumpy,
a lot of air. And yeah, that concludes the repot for this baby. Oh, I got my terracotta while I'm over here. Swinging it around. I'm gonna be falling off the edge. But yeah, that'll do her. That'll do her. Let's set her up. Fix her leaves up a little bit. Babies, I thank you guys for coming. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Yes, and hit the notification bell so you can come back and see a girl the next time. But you never know what she's gonna be up to. She does a lot.
Too much. No, I can never. Because I'm gonna do what the hell I'm gonna want to do. Yes, I am. Whatever I feel it's in my heart to do, I'm gonna do.
Yes, Lord, whatever He tell me to do, I'm come to. So yeah, He told me to cut off these extra strips here. Don't forget them pieces. And I'll see y'all on the next one, okay? Remember, stay rooted and never ever forget who loves you, baby. Deuces, and I'll holla. Bye-bye. Bye. Say bye. Thanks for coming. Toodles. Taking a closer look, she will be giving a new leaf shortly. I will say in about a few weeks. About a few weeks or so. Because she is so preggo. Yes, yes, yes. All right. Stay tuned. We'll see how happy she is in her new home.